I'm good. How are you?
Doing good, Bruce. Good to see you today. How's
yeah,
the day?
Bye.
How was the day so far?
Yeah, so good. Just
fantastic, fantastic. So, Moose, your sophomore album, Death Melodies, is to be out on March 8th. Would you like to tell me a bit about the songwriting and production behind this new album?
We started writing the songs for this album back in 2019, just before COVID hit. So we were all together in LA and just started jamming for a couple of days. And the first song we wrote was Broken Bones, which is one of the singles off Death Melodies. And then the pandemic hit, so we were restricted to writing online and sharing files via the internet and stuff. And then so a couple of songs came that way, like Man Without a Face was written that way. And then if you were vaccinated, the Canadian borders opened. So British people and US people could go to Canada. So me and the boys decided, let's do 10 days in Canada. And we wrote about five or six songs in Canada and then finished the rest of the album while we were recording it. So it was quite strange.
Interesting. And was there any particular concept or a theme that goes behind this album?
We didn't think so as we were writing the songs, but then we realized that James's lyrics are all about death. And one of the working titles for one of the songs was Death Melodies. And I said, well, seems like every song is titled Death or Die, or the song is about that subject. Why don't we call the album Death Melodies and call this song something else? And everyone was like, that's a good idea. So we did.
And the title sounds so awesome.
It does, doesn't it? I've been arguing with my wife for the last 2 years. And she was like, you should have called the album Broken Bones. I'm like, no way. It's Death Melodies. It's way cooler.
Fantastic, fantastic. And I was talking about the album, 10, 12 mind-blowing metal anthems, I would say. Beautifully written, great musicianship. The vocals are fantastic. And each and every one of the band has done an awesome job this album. So I want to thank you guys so much for putting up this amazing album this year. And as a band, how do you guys feel about the outcome?
Well, thank you very much. It's really nice to hear feedback because we've just been sat with it, you know, for the last 2 years now. I'm thinking, oh, is it good enough to be released, you know, because we thought the Sinner was really good, the album before. And we was like, that's going to be really hard to top this. And but for you guys now to say that you really like it and we've done a good job, that means it's a lot of pressure off our shoulders. So, yeah, we are really excited to finally release the album now.
Interesting. And a few weeks back, you released your video From Ashes from this album. And would you like to tell me a bit about the making of this video?
Yeah, I think it was last March. We all flew to Minneapolis to shoot. We shot all the videos in 2 days. So it was five videos in 2 days, which was, it was pretty fun, actually. It was like nonstop. And From Ashes came about. Zeb, the director, just said, set up your gear. And then he just started shaking all this like ceiling insulation on us, which looked like ashes. And it was kind of dusty, but it was kind of fun. And the track was actually half sped up or something. It was a lot faster than it is now. So we had to play double time. And then he slowed the video down and you see what you see now. So it was weird, but fun.
Fantastic. And like you said, you have already released five videos, but do you have some plans to come up with one more video close to the release date?
Yeah, when's this interview going up? Because we have there's another one coming out Friday, this Friday coming, so I don't know when this is coming out. So there'd be another one. The next video is Sleep with the Devil. That's gonna be before the album, and then we're gonna release another song with the album.
Fantastic, fantastic. And any big plans on the day of the release on March 8th?
Yes, we're busy booking live shows. So we'll be get our teeth into that now in this year, 2024. So hopefully it's going to be bullet touring for us. And I'm sure when we're always together, we'll always start writing anyway. It'll just be a natural thing. And we're already 4 songs into album 3 as well. So that's just going to be a natural progression as well.
And 2024, does 2024 take you guys to overseas?
We're working on it. What do you mean by overseas in America?
Anywhere around the world.
Yeah, we're definitely UK and Europe so far, and where we want to be with this band is because we want to be in America because everyone's there. I mean, half the band are there. Well, 3/4 of the band are there. Our record label's there, so we need to be really after the UK and Europe. We need to be focusing on America.
And how has this journey with Kill the Lights been for you guys so far?
Very strange but fun. Obviously, we started the band with intentions to release music and tour, but that got put on hold because of the pandemic. So we had to release an album in a pandemic on in lockdown and not being able to tour. So me and the guys just decided to we had all our time off, so we just decided just to focus on album number 2. That's why there was not really much touring from the band, because we were just like, there's no point in touring. There was like a massive queue from tours that got put back. No one was interested in booking a new band to go on tour. So we were like, we just concentrate on writing an album. So it was very fun. When we're together, we have hilarious times, but it was just a very strange, weird time to be a musician, and now we're looking forward for a cl clean slate now in 2024.
And any highlight moments for the band that you want to share with me today?
Any highlight performance? We did Download 2 years ago, and that was pretty special because Download's a big place for myself and Jay. You know, that's where we started in Bullet and stuff, and Andy, the promoter, who books all the bands for Download, he was a big part of pushing Bullet and stuff. And he was there, he was watching and giving us his support and stuff. So it was probably the highlight of the band's career so far, is playing Download again.
Fantastic. And being 2024 gonna be dedicated more on the touring part, and what will be next for Kill the Lights?
Just more touring, hopefully. Lots of surprises. Just touring, that we are completely focused now on touring this year. We'll write more songs and demo them, and hopefully there won't be a big gap between album 3 to what it was for album 1 and 2.
Sounds amazing. Sounds amazing. And finally, any message that you have for the fans around the world?
Yeah, thanks for sticking around when there was nothing happening. There was stuff happening, but they probably didn't know. And if they're a new fan and they like the music, then thank you very much. And just remember that Death Melodies is out on April, no, March the 8th. Sorry.
And Moose, I want to thank you so much for your time today and for this amazing interview that you are doing with me. And also, I want to thank you and the entire band for Death Melodies, which is to be out on March 8th. A fantastic album, like I said earlier. Totally loving it, each and every song to the perfection. Totally loving each and every song. So I want to thank you so much, guys, for this album. And I'm really hoping to see you guys on the road. And take care and have a good day.
Perfect. Thank you very much for your kind words. See you later.
Bye-bye.